That's Ken Corley. Well, as with other speakers, I welcome the bill, and I think it is very positive that the government have put what is clearly substantial work into this bill. And as has been said, it is a bill that's well overdue, 100 years since the primary bill in this area was put on the statute books, the Protection of Animals Act in 1911. So I think it's long overdue that we would update that legislation and ensure a greater level of protection for animals and take measures and put in place controls to prevent cruelty to animals. And obviously, the other aspect of the bill about controlling disease is one that I think we're all aware, given the foot and mouth scares and other outbreaks of contagious disease, the importance of having legislation updated to empower the government and authorities to take actions and put in place measures which will prevent the control of disease. So I think all of that is very welcome. And in the area of animal welfare and preventing animal cruelty, as my colleague Deputy Daly has already said, I think all the being more specific in the areas of animal welfare and the prevention of cruelty in the way the bill does is very, very positive, including things like abandonment, as being a form of cruelty, not looking properly after animals and pets, measures to prevent people engaging in animal fighting, mutilation of animals, controls on the laying of poison and so on, the sale of animals to minors, and increased penalties in areas where people, do engage in animal cruelty or don't provide, don't ensure the proper welfare of animals that are in their possession or in their ownership. I think all those are good, are very positive things, and the regime of authorised inspectors, I think, is also a very positive development. Although, as Deputy Daly said, it is difficult to square these positive measures and commitments, if you like, to upgrade the level of protection for animals against a background where staff numbers are being run down in local authorities as a result of the public sector recruitment embargo. So it would be interesting to hear from the Minister how he intends to square that circle, but there is a problem with just pious aspiration, legislative or otherwise, if it is not matched with resources. It's an issue that we'll come on to as well when it comes to the referendum on children's rights and the Children's First guidelines as well. You know, it's all very well having legislative protections, but if you don't have the resources to back them up, you wonder really what they mean and how they can be enforced. So I think those are serious questions for the government to answer as to how that will be done. One other item, possibly a bit parochial, although I'm sure it's an issue elsewhere as well, is insofar as the government, by bringing forward this bill, is stating its commitment to animal welfare and, if you like, an improved regime to ensure that that occurs. I think local authorities, or we should think about how local authorities may facilitate animal owners and in ensuring that they can provide properly, if you like, for animals. I mean, I'm thinking in my own area about how there was a big dispute between dog owners and the local authorities over their right to walk their animals on the beach. Now, there's a real issue, if you like, between other users of the beach and children and so on at certain times and being afraid of dogs and the right of animal owners to exercise their dogs. And exercise for dogs is very important in ensuring, you know, the proper care of a dog. If you don't walk a dog, it can actually amount to a form of cruelty if dogs or other animals aren't properly exercised. But I think that the minister may also be a matter for the Minister for the Environment, but I think we need to think about ensuring that local authorities understand that they have to try and provide facilities, you know, off-leash hours or particular areas in parks or whatever, and ensuring that that's not just done on an ad hoc basis by local authorities, but there's some sort of regime to try and accommodate this situation and a process for of consultation with animal owners and with, if you like, other stakeholders in the issue so that reasonable compromises can be reached between animal owners and local authorities and other people who are concerned in the issue where there are disputes, but ensuring the welfare of animals in that regard. So all of that is positive, but as Deputy Daly indicated, the one big gaping omission in this bill is the fact that where you very well define what animal cruelty is and the need in most cases to put, you know, to make it illegal to engage in cruelty against animals, you then give two specific opt-outs in the area of hare coursing and hunting, fox hunting. And that really is unacceptable and difficult to understand. I mean, what possible justification for is there? If you define as you do well what cruelty means, causing unnecessary suffering to animals, how can you then say that cruelty in some circumstances can be allowed or justified or excluded, if you like, from trying to establish a humane regime for the treatment of animals? And it seems to me you simply can't justify that exclusion, and you shouldn't, and that the bill needs to be amended in that regard, because hare coursing does involve cruelty to animals in all the ways Deputy Daly described, and fox hunting also involves cruelty and suffering for those animals. And it is not something that the vast majority of people in this country want or support. And outlawing this form of cruelty doesn't endanger traditional pursuits, because as you know, has been well debated and discussed, I don't need to inform the Minister of this, there are humane alternatives where those activities can be carried on in other ways through drag coursing, that don't require the suffering of animals. And I think the Minister should take his lead from Northern Ireland, for example, where they have banned hare coursing, that we should do the same. And there should be no exemptions. Cruelty to animals is cruelty to animals, and quite simply, it shouldn't be allowed. So I welcome the bill, but I think it's important that the government make those amendments and remove those exclusions on hare coursing and fox hunting.
Come on.